Well, despite the growing number of states that have legalized cannabis for adult use, marijuana is still considered an illegal substance under federal law, preventing most of the big banks from providing services to dispensaries.
And now Maryland Attorney General Anthony Brown is urging congressional leaders to change that. Caroline Forback has a story.
The cannabis industry is booming, but dispensaries are constantly jumping through hoops just to facilitate transactions.
CFO of Nature's Care and Wellness in Perryville, Robert Windsor, says while business has taken off since Maryland legalized recreational cannabis, it's been an uphill battle behind the scenes.
It's been very challenging for the cannabis industry when it comes to banking.
Because cannabis is still considered illegal under federal law, big banks could risk civil or criminal liability for providing services to state-licensed dispensaries, making it difficult for these businesses to find funding.
Just because I'm affiliated with the cannabis industry, they wanted me to bank elsewhere.
It's also caused issues when it comes to processing transactions, leaving many dispensaries only able to accept cash.
I had been through several processing companies that said they can do it, and then I would get shut down like 4 months later.
This week, Maryland Attorney General Anthony Brown announced he's leading a coalition of 22 attorneys general to urge Congress to advance the Safer Banking Act of 2023, which would lift those banking restrictions. Brown said in a press release, legal cannabis businesses should have access to funding that provides them opportunities equal to other industries to grow, contribute to the economy, and create new jobs. This is particularly important for small, minority-owned, and women-owned businesses, which have faced disproportionately high barriers to accessing funding. Windsor says he was eventually able to find a processing system that would let them accept credit cards, but the Safer Banking Act would provide stability.
How long that will last? I have no idea.
Windsor says some banks like CFG have figured out a way to work with cannabis businesses, and he hopes other banks will do the same. Reporting in Perryville, Caroline Forback, WJZ.